Hello Earthlings, you're watching Adam the Alien. It's August 21st, 2017 as I'm recording this, and I am looking right at a solar eclipse happening right now, and I am nerding out like I can't even describe. I have always seen pictures and I've seen videos and time lapses, but I don't think anything can really compare to just
being there.
Laying my eyes on this. It's not even total yet. Yeah. And I have been waiting my whole life for this experience, and it is not disappointing, and it's not even at the height yet. I feel like I'm word salading. I can't express how incredible this is.
There's going to be another solar eclipse starting from the middle of Texas and going up through Maine.
All right.
In April 8th, 2024. Make your reservations now.
So what we're saying is, yeah, in 7 years, I'm going to be out east doing this again.
Yeah. We need to find some place that's not going to be raining in April. Right. is what we're saying.
There have been helicopters and planes flying all over. I wonder what it's like to be in the air while this is going on. The moon is becoming a crescent. Yeah, you just heard right. I called the sun the moon. But I mean, look at this. Can you blame me? It looks a lot more like the moon than the sun. It looks like a cookie with a bite out of it. Never has it looked so much like it looked on things like Sesame Street. This is like the classic stylized cartoonish moon.
Yeah.
Except it's the sun.
That's right. And it's going to be much more of a crescent pretty soon.
Yeah.
It's getting really dark and kind of cold.
Normally I'd have my sunglasses on because it's too bright. Even when you're not looking anywhere near the sun, and now it's like, it reminds me of when there's smoke in the air. Except there's no smoke in the air.
It's 9:51, and I don't know how well my cameras are gonna show this, but it's definitely gotten darker, and the lighting's kind of getting eerie, isn't it? It's not normal seeming lighting. It's not like how it usually gets dark. It's so weird. This is very eerie. Yeah, it is getting cold. Oh, this is amazing!
Cold. It's probably still like 70 something.
I know, but when it starts in the 90s. The temperature is changing. It's getting cooler. The sky is darker. I don't think the camera's gonna be able to capture any of that, but it's so eerie.
Darn you auto exposure.
Wow, look at the sky over there. It's just the shade of everything. Just that weird dimness. I'm getting so excited. This is amazing. This is amazing. You excited, Joel?
I'm very excited.
It's 10:05, it's almost total. It's getting so much darker, and the breeze is getting chillier and chillier. The colors of everything around me are getting eerier and eerier, and there's no way the camera's catching it.
No. It's probably all bright and shiny and wonderful in the camera.
Exactly. It's not even total yet, and I just can't stop thinking about the fact that this is definitely not something that can be properly experienced through a camera. You've got to see a full total eclipse in your life.
Banana!
Like, seriously. That is... Oh my god. I'm where Adam was 10 minutes
ago.
Just enjoy what you're seeing.
Yeah, he's all chill now.
No, dude, I'm crying.
Oh, this is so cool.
You're so excited. Oh, there we go.
I'm so excited. Look at that.
Oh, did you finally get it?
I switched from auto.
The light has gotten even eerier.
Here it comes.
Here it comes. Oh shoot, here it comes. No words can accurately describe what I experienced during that brief period of totality. It was unreal. I felt like I was in a dream. It truly seemed like I'd stepped into another world, a world that could only exist in fantasy. Nothing could prepare me for it. No photograph, no time lapse, no impossibly expensive special effects in any movie or show. In a time when we, as a people, are increasingly difficult to impress, this completely blew me away. The Eclipse totality was just a little more than 1 minute of my life, but it changed me. How much, I don't yet know. But it was unlike any other experience I've ever had. The sight of the sun blocked by the moon, the mountains still glowing on the horizon, the sight of my friends and family in lighting I never would have believed to be natural, the confused wildlife quickly trying to go to sleep or wake up, thinking the night had come. It was all beyond breathtaking. Around me, the reactions were strong, ranging from awestruck silence to loud euphoria, from a giddy panic to an inexplicable flood of tears. Throughout history, eclipses have been seen as world-changing, whether as portents of doom or merely a sign of change. It's easy to see why people would put such significance in the event. The eclipse brought forth a strange, beautiful, almost frightening mix of emotions that I can't even begin to describe. Until that moment, I don't think I've ever grasped the full meaning of the word awe. But that's what I was. I was in awe.
Shit, that was cool.
So in the lead up to the eclipse, I saw this TED talk in which a formerly skeptical science reporter who became an eclipse evangelist and an eclipse chaser talked about the idea that you owe it to yourself at least once before you die to see a total solar eclipse. I agree, that was just the briefest of experiences, but it was so incredible and so unlike anything else. I don't even know how to fully describe it. It was just amazing, and now I want it again. I'm now an eclipse addict. Look at this. The light still feels weird. The warmth is still trying to come back. This is.
I'm still crying.
I don't know how to describe this. I need it again. 7 years. I'm going east. Hours have passed now, and I am still processing the eclipse and its effect. And all I can think is that everyone seems to agree that it felt dreamlike and very surreal. There's nothing quite like it. It really is a unique experience. And I'm addicted now. I need my next fix. Hopefully sooner than 7 years from now, if I can get to another continent. Until next time, I'm Adam the Alien. Fare thee well.